if you say you're a beamer, people automatically, like, they get kind of a little suspicious, I guess. Like, if you take it too seriously, if you think of yourself as a beamer and you're, like, proud of that, it's, like, weird. Like, it's weird to be serious about it. It's weird to have it as, like, a hobby. Like, you enjoy it. It's a thing. For most people, it's just, like, when memes come to them, they enjoy them.
Back when I started, it was always, if you didn't fit in, you just kind of went to memes.
All right. This is my favorite meme. This one is me and Antonio together. So I used to run a meme page for, it was mainly based off the UB Running Club. The whole point was to kind of meme for the club, you know, give people something to look at on social media, maybe something funny to laugh at.
I had already gotten to know some of the people that were more serious about running, but UB Running Memes helped me branch out and meet a lot more people there.
I had admins there with me. We were all posting content we thought was appropriate, was funny. Sometimes we went a little too far and we had to retract some statements we made. What made UB Running Memes a success was the absolute contemporary memes. Now what that is like, you would go to practice and someone would say something funny and everyone laughs and it was a good joke. And then by the time you got home, somebody already made a meme about it. Like, they were thinking about it all practice. They were thinking, like, while they're running, it's gonna look like this. And they would go home and there it was. My chicken wasn't even done defrosting for dinner and the meme was already out.
It was able to be embraced by everyone else. There was no one saying, like, oh, this is offensive, get this out of here.
When you have a small group, small target, it's very easy to know that target and to be current.
I actually started making a lot more content. It was stuff I was willing to put out more publicly.
A lot of people were excited. Oh, you know, Alex is here, because that meant memes. That meant memes today. If I was there, memes were coming.
We found some really good memes. We definitely struck gold a few times, and then we just kept going with it. Like, we held on as long as we could, I guess you could say.
Working for the page was the ride. It wasn't like the joy that people got from it, really. I think it was the brotherhood between me and other admins of getting together and making these memes and sending them privately in a little group saying, like, is this appropriate? And always having to get, like, morally checked.
The difference between good and offensive is an imaginary line that constantly shifts and changes on a literally day-to-day basis of just the way people feel, what's happened.
You want to push the boundaries without being too targeting. And there was a few memes that we didn't post because they were too offensive or too vulgar. But the ones that got right at the margin were the best. Hopefully, you know, you see the Mr. Worldwide meme was a good one. It was a really good one about...
I definitely did get kind of made into a meme.
SemGod? I started SemGod when I saw at Circle Introduction there was a kid with the same name as me, Alex. And I was like, all right, easy name to remember. I'll always know who he is.
And I would just kind of run on my own. I wouldn't really talk to anybody because, you know, kind of a quiet person.
Then I noticed this, like, kid not talk to anyone and not join anyone. And I was thinking, like, oh, wow, that really sucks. Like, what can I do to get this kid to be more involved and feel better? Because he looks sad. So I just started saying, obviously I'm going to spread a rumor. What's, like, the nicest rumor I can spread? So I just, you know, he would run on his own, and I would say, you know, he's running on his own because he's just too fast for everyone. He's too good. He's going too far. No one can keep up with him. And that way, you know, he starts becoming spoken about.
I don't know. The other memers just kind of took a liking to me for some reason, you know? I just...
Like, you know, looking like Bob Ross and Post Malone, or I guess Post Ross or Bob Malone, we'll call him. We'd make these jokes, but then we started talking and we get to know the guy, you know, saying, oh, he's such a god, you know.
It became a religion where, like, I was the god figure.
He wasn't like, oh, you guys are rude or mean. He liked the jokes, thought it was funny.
And there was like a cryptocurrency for a little while, some coin. People who were never in the running club and don't really know anyone in the running club just started calling me some god out of nowhere.
So a very comical fellow. Prop comedy is good on him. He's the prop.
It was just weird. It just took some adjusting. Like, I didn't choose this as a nickname. I didn't I don't really understand where it even started anyway, but it was just part of my life now, and it's weird. The way meme culture is these days, it's just short-lived. Like, you get a meme, you just meme about it for a few days, and then you stop because you're afraid people are gonna call it stale. Even if it's not stale, then they just say it's stale anyway, because, like, you know, the joke's been used up. People kind of have that down a little bit too much. Like, they think, like, this is the meme right now, this is what's in, and then you give it, like, 2 weeks, and then you drop it. It's old, you have to move on. And so it's like, memes die too quickly, and you go through these long stretches where there's just not many memes.
It's contradictory to the definition of the word meme, which specifically refers to a viral piece of media that's spread over a large group.
Now, all these kids are making memes and it's popular. That's the cool thing. It wasn't cool, you were anti-cool.
When memes get up there, they die. When they get on TV, they die.
It kind of feels like the culture's almost been taken away from us. It's been appropriated into the mainstream.
More companies are trying to use my love to make money, and it's sad to see what you love get taken and used by corporate greed.
It did fall pretty quickly for how long it was actually there for. I was only part of the UB Running Memes page for a few months.
Memes ended when I couldn't trust people. I started getting really petty. It could have lasted much longer, but at the time, I was getting really discouraged by running. It just hurt too much. Like, my body hit its toll. I've survived too many motorcycle accidents and sports injuries.
Yeah, we had almost 200 posts in like a couple months, pretty much. I mean, we were just constantly going, and people were still enjoying it. You know, at a certain point, it's too much, but no, it was working. It was fine.
Memes ended when I got petty.
Myself included. Everyone started becoming petty. The memes became a tiny bit more targeted toward people. It was just, the atmosphere had changed and people didn't want to address it up front.
Another issue arose when election time, there was a position for social media manager, and I came up and I gave a pitch like, look, I've been running social media for you guys out of my own free will. No one asked for this. There's no prior person. This is all new ground that I decided to do out of pure joy. And I'm running it. Everyone loves it. No one has complained because we take complaints seriously on the meme page.
People weren't willing to say, like, well, I didn't like that meme, maybe.
And comes someone, the other person running for the position, who just said, I have an Instagram, who posts once a month and says it'd be something she would like to do.
We worked so hard to become memers. We wanted this to be what we are, and like, this is what we do at this club. But then there were a lot of moments where we felt like, you know, you're just the clown. You're the punchline to these jokes.
And I was very upset the fact that I can do something out of the joy of doing it, and come time to pick someone who should be held accountable for that position, I thought, you know, it was a popularity contest, because clearly we presented what we were doing. Everyone loved it. If anyone opposed it, they would have mentioned it earlier.
Our whole group kind of ran and didn't get elected for anything, so it felt like, you know, we weren't really wanted there anymore. Nothing against any of the members. Like, I'm still friends with them today. It's just that, like, our group as a unit existing in that club just for some reason didn't work out. So, you know, just went our separate ways.
It's hard to do a better job when we were on fire with everything and everyone. So I was hurt, and that's what led to the demise.
It was definitely a weird part of my life that I kind of miss. I didn't really think I would as much. While we were in it, it was just kind of like, whatever, a little thing. It's just a meme page. They're just memes, but now that's not there anymore, it's like, there's definitely something missing, and that's the meme page. The fact that there were always these memes we could make and post. It's like, you know, miss that.
It hurt pretty bad. But I moved on by making memes about different things. I'm on this new genre of deep fried audio memes. That's my new kick.
Some information from your credit cards. I've obtained new power. Let me give you a taste of my own comic form!
No one to entertain but ourselves, and things got kind of boring. But then this new Kanye video dropped and it went viral. Just the costume design was ridiculous. They looked like Roblox people, but then they just saw it. They had this short window. Like, you have to make a meme about this weekend, because if you wait longer, people aren't gonna think it's funny anymore. It pretty much epitomizes like the difference between being a casual memer and actually making it like something you do. They actually went out, got their supplies, built stuff, and then they did it that night. Like, they just, in a matter of hours, just a great meme. Everybody loved it. They were completely taken by surprise. Like, whatever was gonna come to that party that night, they didn't expect Box Kanye, but it came. You should, you know, make the art that you yourself would want to enjoy, so there should be the satisfaction of just creating the costumes themselves. You could have a lot of fun with them, you don't really need an audience, but then, you know, having somewhere to show it off and having it be appreciated, especially to that extent, I mean, even if you were expecting appreciation for that, like, they didn't expect it on that level. The whole party, like, you were just the center of attention and everyone loved it. It was really a special moment as beamers, honestly.